Hey everybody, so I'm back for another Love It or Leave It, and it's featuring a new nail polish I've been testing out. I have shown a couple of you on my Snapchat a few sneak peeks of it, and I posted like once on Twitter, but mostly I keep all of my sneak peeks on my Snapchat, so if you want to, you can follow me on there. It's the same screen name as just about everything. It's Samage, just like this channel, across all of my social media. Anywho, it's brand new, it's available at Sephora, it's limited edition, and it's from my favorite nail polish brand at Sephora called Nails Inc. If you haven't watched me for a while, you might have heard me rave and rave about their gel effect polishes, which I honestly don't use as much anymore just because I've been testing out so many things, but they are still probably my favorite polishes at Sephora. And I was there buying like one of their new like six packs of the gel effects, and I saw this on the website. So not every store carries it, you can check on Sephora's website if your store does, but it's kind of new, and they are spray can nail polishes. I know, a little strange. So this is like a does it really work, love it or leave it kind of mesh review video. And we'll keep it short and sweet. So I have the two polish colors that it comes in. I ordered them online. I have the kind of metallic silver, and I can't pronounce it, but it'll be on the screen. And then I have the Mayfair Lane, which is supposed to be Nudie Pink, which they have a gel effect polish that is this name. Looks nothing like this, honestly. They don't look the same at all for some reason. I thought this would be more pink. The sticker on it gives that impression. It's more nude. You'll see. I got close-up shots for you. And aside from that, you have to buy, or you should at least, the 2-in-1 base and top coat that is the paint can polish's best friend. It literally says it on there. It's super tiny. This is $8 while these are $12. And this is so tiny because you can see compared to like a full size nail ink, like base coat, look at it. It's dinky, but you need it supposedly. So how it works, you paint the base coat on, let that dry. Shake this up, spray it 4 to 6 inches to your fingers, let that dry. That's the hard part, being patient and letting it dry, because it dries on your skin way faster, or dry on your counter or whatever the heck you paint over, or napkin, way faster, but you have to let it dry. I kind of like rushed it a little bit with my first like test with the silver polish. You'll see it's a little streaky, but at the same time, I only did one coat. You could do two coats if you want to, but I did one. I'm sure two coats will look a little better, but as far as it drying, And then you paint the top coat on, let that dry. After everything is dry, you can wash off the polish from your hands, wipe it off with a Lysol wipe on whatever you paint it on top of, or acetone if you need to, and it comes off. I only needed to use some soapy water, and that's what's instructed, to get it off your fingers, and that's all good. You kind of have to scrape it a little bit more. I will say the pink or the nude dries way faster than the silver, super fast. The silver was easier to come off when it was washing. The nude literally sunk into my hands. My hands felt like old and crusty, and I had to like use my nails to kind of scrape it off of my skin a little bit. It didn't hurt. I'm just saying there's a little difference between both of those formulations. And then it just stays on whatever area has the base and top coat. It kind of gets on your cuticles a little bit. It's not the cleanest look, and I mean, you can touch that up if you want to with a little acetone, but all in all, it was okay. It definitely works, but I don't think it is the best thing ever. Maybe in different shades. They're very metallic. Very, very metallic. Even the Nudie Pink was very odd. I would rather it have been cream or, you know, something else. I didn't really like the super shiny pink. The silver was fine. It definitely looks good if you wanted like metallic silver. I don't think these are must-haves. They are fun to try. They are fun to use. It's definitely something that is quick and easy. If you just don't have time to mess around with anything else, then it's something worth trying for 12 bucks. But they're definitely not the most travel-friendly. They're not the most reasonable thing. But I guess it's unique. I'll go with that. I don't know if I would say I love it, but I don't say I would leave it either. It's just kind of eh, okay, fun to try and fun to test. So it's up to you guys if you want to check them out or not. Let me know down below what you think about spray-on polishes, and I would love to hear that. So thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.